So hi all, welcome to the Cricket Revolved podcast.
Hey man, it couldn't have been a better day to start our podcast. What a match did we have today? England versus Sri Lanka, and how many would have expected Sri Lanka to win today? What do you think went right for Sri Lanka today?
Yeah, absolutely one cracker of a match. And Sri Lanka, man, whoever thought they will be playing such a sort of a game. And that too against the world number one side. Start off, you can say, team selection. Straight away putting in Avishka Fernando in place of Sirimane.
Mm-hmm.
That was quite a bold call.
Mm-hmm.
He straight away just gave a fresh start to Sri Lanka. So that was great. Means after having lost two wickets, that sort of an innings of 49 of 39 balls just gave the impetus from where the likes of Mendes and Matthews could just build upon. In the previous matches, we saw the top order scoring runs, the bulk of the runs. But here, the middle order just showed up. So that helped them to put up a fighting total on this pitch. So that's it. And what do you think, what went wrong, if at all, during the first inning from England's point of view?
Well, England, I don't think there's much England could have done in the first innings. But I thought everything went wrong in the second innings for them. So the thing is, what the best thing about this match is, this proves that in a World Cup stage, in a World Cup pressure, there's no team that is invincible. And the best thing about today's match is the wicket. The Leeds wicket wasn't a flat track where England could, you know, chase down their 400 and 500 ambitions. This was a wicket where both the teams had to play some proper cricket. And what Sri Lanka did was they played through the 50 overs. And what England didn't do is they're not able to play through the 50 overs. The match was decided right then and there. And this shows how important it is for a team to play through the 50 overs, especially for teams batting first, because you never know what that one extra run can add up to your end result, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, and then I thought England, okay, they're definitely missing Jason Roy. That James Wynne has come straight in. He's a good talent. I mean, don't mistake me for that. But Jason Roy is a class apart, and today it seemed like they're missing him. And Johnny Bairstow doesn't seem to be the guy who goes on a consistent run. And at least in this World Cup, he's not been that consistent. And today's wicket was a very sporty wicket. It's not a wicket where England can, you know, go bash and finish out the match in 30 overs or so. And I think in England fell in trap of their own reputation as this a New England, which is a counter-attacking team. This wasn't a wicket where you show off your counter-attacking skills. This was a wicket where you play sensibly and take your team through. And that's why the innings from Joe Root and Ben Stokes stands out, because they haven't tried any rash shots at any point of time. They were playing right with the bowlers at their merit. I thought where England lost was the brainless batting from the lower middle order. That was Jos Buttler. You expect better from Jos Buttler. You expect better from someone like Moeen Ali. Yeah, Moeen Ali. He slog sweeped a six, and then hindsight you can say, but that's the role Moeen Ali is supposed to do, take away the game from the opposition. And I also felt the tailenders could have stuck and supported Ben Stokes better. Ben Stokes was this close to, you know, becoming an all-time legend today. If he would have pulled this match off with the 10th wicket stand and all, he would have been, you know, Ian Botham equivalent. He missed it today. But the best thing about today's match, man, is the whole table is now open for everyone. Now Sri Lanka can fancy their chance to be in the top four.
All this
while we were thinking England, Australia, India and New Zealand are through to the semis. But no, hang on, England is gonna meet New Zealand, India and Australia in the next three matches. And okay, this is really spicing up, and England is under pressure now. And I think the best teams perform under pressure. So let's see how England goes on from here on.
Right.
Yeah.
And what happens with Sri Lanka over here is that in the second innings, you could see that the thing in them that they are banking on their bowlers, you know,
yeah,
a lot. I mean, they actually like to put some target on the board and then defend it with their bowlers. So they have got that confidence, and Malinga gives them that thing leading from the front. So that was an absolute pleasure to watch a legend yet again proving himself at the biggest platform.
Yep.
And turning up for his side whenever needed. in all the Chelsea goals, right from the first till the last one. He kept the pressure up and he kept on taking crucial wickets. And the captaincy of Karunaratne was very good, was absolutely spot on. And then you could see the introduction of Dhananjay De Silva, who eventually ended up with 3 wickets. So that too, at a point of time when someone had to support Malinga from the other end to keep the pressure up and also chip in with a few wickets. So, what a great turnaround.
Absolutely, the team had the belief.
Yeah.
The team had the belief, and that's the best thing. And this was a must-win match, and Lasith Malinga did it for them. The captain was persistent. The team wasn't giving up, which is, that was a beaut. Let's see how Sri Lanka goes on from here. At least the World Cup's now all exciting now. It's
absolutely.
This was
we
very.
Can't wait for the rest of the match.
Yeah, this was very much important to the World Cup. This had to be happening. This was a welcome upset in the World Cup.
Great. So we'll move on to our next podcast soon.
Yeah.
That's all for this one.
Yeah. Cheers, man.